Welcome to Travel with Sean. I'm Sean, and today is going to be a little different. We're going to be visiting some German concentration camps where the Nazis imprisoned Jewish people, gypsies, and others. I gotta warn you, it's not for the faint of heart. Some serious conversation, serious discussion of human atrocities that were committed by the Nazis. I believe that the building we're standing in front of is the original entry building, guard shack, to Dachau concentration camp. This gate is a replica built in 2016 because the original was stolen in 2014. This is the Dachau concentration camp for Nazis controlling the Jews. And the sign on the entrance says, "Work makes free." It was originally for opponents to the Nazi party as a labor camp.
The Dachau concentration camp was established for political prisoners in March 1933 in a former World War I munitions plant. This was the model for all future concentration camps and was under the command of the SS. Built in 1936, the Jahr House was the gatehouse and office building for the SS. This was the operational center for the camp. The Gestapo also had interrogation rooms here for any prisoners accused of violating camp rules or accused of resistance.
In front of us is the roll call ground. Prisoners were forced to stand at attention in the roll call ground for at least an hour, sometimes more, twice a day. They would have to stand at attention motionless. If anyone fell, they would be punished in front of everyone, and no one was allowed to help anyone who fell. If the head count did not match how many people were supposed to be here, then the prisoners were kept longer until they were able to resolve the difference.
The maintenance building was built by prisoners in 1936 and 1937. The building contained workshops for the prisoners to do work benefiting the mission of the Third Reich. Newly arrived prisoners had to report here to be registered. The next step was to strip naked and hand over their clothing and all possessions. The room was divided in two by a long row of tables in between the pillars. New arrivals stood on one side and turned over their clothing and possessions to prisoners standing on the other side who were assigned to this duty. In the 1930s, the Nazis discussed options for what they called the Jewish question, which was what to do with the Jews. What they came up with was called the final solution, which was concentration camps where they would determine who they could use in the war effort, and those they could not use were to be executed or exterminated. The SS had a penal code for the concentration camp, but individual SS guards were allowed to punish, torture, and execute prisoners on a whim. Common punishments included beatings with caned whips, pole hangings for an hour or more, standing at attention for an hour or more, denial of meals. During the beatings, prisoners being beaten were required to count aloud the number of beatings received. If the prisoner misspoke the number or was not clearly understandable because of pain, they had to restart counting. Every barracks building was designed to house 208 prisoners in four rooms. There was one toilet room and one washroom for every two rooms of 52 prisoners each. The camp was designed to house 6,000 prisoners, but when it was liberated in 1945, there were 32,000 survivors, and there had been over 25,000 documented executions.
This area over here was off limits to the prisoners and fenced off. This is where the SS raised Angola rabbits, and they used their fur as lining for the Luftwaffe, the German Air Force coats.
This is the entrance to the SS recreation area.
This area was originally supposed to be a recreation area for the SS. Now this is a Catholic chapel and Carmelite convent, or at least it used to be a convent formed in 1965.
The entire camp was surrounded with an electrified barbed wire fence. In certain places like here, they had a 7 to 8 foot deep trench to make it harder for anyone to escape. If anyone was caught trying to escape, they could be shot on sight. If they were not shot, they would be brought back to the roll call ground to be punished while everyone watched. And you see right over here, there is a guard tower where they could easily be caught.
Now we're at Lager Kaufering number 7. This is a subcamp of the Dachau concentration camp. In 1944, Allied bombing raids in Bavaria were becoming more and more common, and the Nazis were concerned that it would hinder their weapons manufacturing. So they wanted to create underground weapons manufacturing facilities, but they needed the labor force to do it, and they didn't want to pay people. So they imported inmates from various concentration camps, and they built various different sub-camps in this area. We're at Lemberg am Lecht, which is the city of Lemberg on the Lecht River. They had 10 or 12 sub-camps here, and this is number 7. It's the only one preserved. The rest have been totally destroyed and privatized. But this is where they housed the inmates from various concentration camps that were brought here to be slave labor to build the underground weapons manufacturing for the Nazis in the 1944 and 1945 period. Now we're going to go in and have a look. This is a memorial site.
Thank you. This is Auschwitz II, about 1.5 to 2 miles from the Auschwitz-Birkenau camp. And these railroad tracks lead right into the concentration camp. Jews were rounded up in cities all over Nazi Europe and brought here by train. And it wasn't just Jews here either. There were also people known as Roma, or in America they're called gypsies.
Upon arriving at Auschwitz, the Jews would be forced to get off the train and line up into two groups, one line for men, one line for women and children. Then medical professionals and orderlies would inspect them to determine who is fit to work. So those that were determined to be unfit for work were lined up and marched down the road. This road right here. Marched down the road to the gas chambers. The others would be sent to the barracks in the camp to be slave labor. So this is the actual prisoner camp. Prisoners were forced to dig this ditch. It's a drainage ditch.
Auschwitz II had been a horse stables for the Polish army, and the barracks had been horse barns. The bunks looked like they did at Dachau, and there were two long rows of them. The barracks were heated by one stove that would have burned either wood or coal. It wouldn't have warmed the barracks very much, as there was no insulation on the walls, and there was space between the walls and the floor.
So this is the kind of railroad car that the Jews came in on. No windows.
This building was a gas chamber and crematorium where several hundred thousand Jewish men, women, and children were murdered by gas and their bodies burned. The crematorium was also used to dispose of the bodies of prisoners, both Jews and non-Jews, who died from other causes. The Jews were forced down the stairs, made to undress, and then ordered to move into the center room. While there, gas pellets were thrown in to kill them. This gas chamber and crematorium operated from March 1943 to November 1944. Then the SS began to remove evidence of their atrocities, and in November 1944 the camp was dismantled. On January 20, 1945, the SS blew up whatever remained.
This was the kitchen for the camp for the deportees from various countries that the Nazis occupied. The rest of these buildings were the barracks. Probably about 400 in each building. At Auschwitz, they had many separate camps, some for men, some for women and children, some for slave labor, some for the gas chambers. Some were deported from other countries. All of these camps had their own separate electrified barbed wire surrounding the perimeter. And there were guard towers. And these were the marching roads. This barracks was for children and their mothers, whom the Nazis kicked out of certain areas of Poland because they didn't want any Polish people living in that part of Poland. And in 1942, there was an uprising in Warsaw, so they brought in children and adolescents from there
These are the bunks for the children and their mothers and for the adolescents. You can see they're not too much different than what the adults slept in. You can see here that several of the children wrote their names on the wall, saying that they were here.
Now we're at the Auschwitz-Birkenau concentration camp in Poland. We already looked at Dachau concentration camp in German, the Kaufering subcamp of Dachau, and now, as I said, we're at Auschwitz-Birkenau in Poland. We arrived about 2:30, got our ticket, but the earliest entry was for 4:30. So now we've been over at Auschwitz II. There's also an Auschwitz III, which I don't think is open to the public anymore. But we looked around Auschwitz II, saw the barracks, the gas chambers, and the crematoriums, incinerators. It's a sight to see, and we didn't need a ticket, special ticket, to get in to Auschwitz II. Just need to pay for parking. I'm curious to see what sights I will behold in Auschwitz-Birkenau. Let's go get in.
Although entry to Auschwitz-Birkenau is free, be prepared to wait in a long line. Auschwitz-Birkenau, commonly called Auschwitz, was established in 1940 primarily for political prisoners, Soviet POWs, and other perceived enemies of the Nazi regime. Its role was later expanded for extermination purposes. This concentration camp had been a Polish army base before being taken over by the Nazis. It is now a UNESCO World Heritage Site, preserved as a museum and memorial to the Holocaust victims. The camp symbolizes the atrocities committed during World War II, and it serves as a stark reminder of the human capacity for cruelty and the importance of remembering and honoring the victims. I'm standing in the central square at Auschwitz. This is where the SS conducted roll call every day, twice a day. Prisoners had to line up, stand at attention, while all of the prisoners were counted. This shelter was for the SS guard in charge of roll call during inclement weather, while the prisoners stood on the street at attention. In fair weather, he stood by this building. These poles were for the purpose of carrying out the hanging punishment, whereby prisoners were strapped or tied to the pole to hang for an hour or more. These buildings were the infirmary for sick prisoners. Prisoners often called it the waiting room for the crematorium because of the lack of basic medications and medical care, resulting in numerous deaths. Here, they would select the weakest prisoners, not expected to recover quickly, and either execute them by lethal injection or send them to the gas chamber. The SS doctors conducted various medical and pharmacological experiments here, usually ending in the death or permanent disability of the prisoners. These experiments included unnecessary surgeries without anesthesia, injections of deadly diseases, and genetic studies. The most infamous of these doctors was their chief of medicine, Dr. Mengele, known among the prisoners as the Angel of Death. From 1941 to 1943, the end of this corridor was where the SS shot several thousand people, mostly Polish, it became known as Death Wall. This building was the Auschwitz camp jail. Anyone that the Gestapo suspected of breaking camp rules or suspected that they were involved in the resistance would be brought here and tortured in the basement. Anyone sentenced to starvation would also be brought here. Several hundred women prisoners, mostly Jewish, were held in upstairs rooms of this building and used as human guinea pigs for sterilization experiments. Some died from these experiments, while others were murdered so the SS doctors could practice performing autopsies. Those who survived were left with permanent injuries. In 1940, the SS converted this munitions bunker into a crematorium to cremate the bodies of their victims. In the fall of 1941, the largest room, which was being used as a morgue, was converted into an improvised gas chamber, which was the first at Auschwitz. Thousands of Jews were murdered this way within hours of their arrival at Auschwitz. Also, many Soviet POWs and sick prisoners who were deemed unlikely to return to work were also murdered in this gas chamber. In 1943, this building stopped being used as a gas chamber or crematorium because the SS had built four other buildings just for this purpose of being a gas chamber with a crematorium in each.
Thank you for watching. I appreciate your support. Until next time. Bye-bye.